1999 The Podcast is a production of the Cage Club Podcast Network. For more podcasts on movies, comics, and all things pop culture, head to cageclub.me. To contact us with questions, comments, or just to say hi, send us an email at 1999@cageclub.me. You can find me on Twitter at probablyrealjb and Joey at soulpot. And you can follow the show on Twitter at 1999 The Podcast. To support the show, please subscribe, rate, and review wherever you listen to podcasts. The show is written, produced, and edited by us. Welcome to 1999 The Podcast. I am John Brooks.
And I'm Joey Lewandowski. Didn't we just do this? Didn't we just do an episode a week ago? We're back already?
We are back already.
How's England doing in the World Cup?
Great. Great. They are doing great. No, in traditional England fashion, they are not going to win the World Cup.
But I will say most countries don't.
Most countries don't. It's surprising how few countries win the World Cup every year.
It's usually like most years, nobody wins it. It's weird.
Not most years they don't. At best one, I would say.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't think I can think of a time that's been more than one. So, okay, look. First of all, I hope that by the time you hear this, we're all going to be talking about Morocco winning the World Cup.
Wait, when's the final?
The final is yesterday.
Okay.
So, yeah, guys, you all remember the final. Wasn't it great when Morocco won the World Cup? No, I don't know. We're recording this before the final. England has been disqualified. I will say I think they... I get annoyed when England loses the World Cup when they did not perform well. They played the game against France as best as they could. I think they played a great game, and it's just one of those games where it just luck did not go their way, and that's fine. And, like, it sucks, and they'll never win the World Cup in my lifetime and whatever. But I am so impressed with Morocco. It's been really, really fun to watch them play. However far they make it, they have been a phenomenal team to watch, as is Croatia. And yeah, I hope you're all like, well, John, Morocco won the World Cup. So, like, why are you having talking about this? Like, there's more, but whatever. Yeah.
I do have another big update since last episode, though, too. I watched Turning Red and I loved it.
It's really good.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's really good. Go watch Turning Red. So you're all up to date now. And this is our second recap, or as I'm going to call it now, our Roundup episode.
Okay.
Because of Toy Story.
Ooh. So
Woody's Roundup.
Woody's Roundup.
So we called our first recap the Spy Break.
Yes, we did.
The Matrix, and we're going to call this the Roundup because of Woody's Roundup. That was our last episode. So we are at the end of round two, and we have reached a milestone moment where we have recapped all of what we considered the 18 essential movies of 1999.
It's all downhill from here, baby.
So we would just like to thank, first of all, people who have contributed to round two in order. They are Kelly J. Baker, Tessa and Nicole from Doom Generation, Brian's Silliman and Rodriguez, Chris Cluey, Jen Tisdale, Jacob Meyervich, I said it right that time, George Ooh. Freitag, and Aaron Newworth. Thank you guys all so very, very much. We will have all of you, if not most of you, back at some point in the future. And you're welcome to just, like, pop in on our recordings whenever you want.
Except no more Bryans. We've had enough Bryans. Too many Bryans.
Oh, no. Yeah, we are Brian Band from now on. Mm-hmm. From this point forward, there will never be another Brian again until there is, which will be pretty soon, probably.
I will say, even though we've covered the 18 essential films from 1999, one of my favorite movies from that year we have not covered yet.
Several of my favorite movies that are from that year.
Not only have we not covered it, I don't even know if it's been brought up. The Straight Story.
Wow, I didn't know that's one of your favorite. I'm not surprised. It's a great movie, and I'm looking forward to talking about it when it fits mm-hmm. into one of our themes. Look, there's so many fucking movies.
Someone should do a podcast about it, but only one podcast about it.
Yeah, it's the reason why we are the only podcast that's ever talked about this year.
Yep.
Because we're pioneers. That's a great movie. I'm looking forward to it. As you know, like a couple of we've talked about a bunch of comedies that I really love, and two of my favorite comedies ever are from this year, and we have not talked about those yet either. Some of the movies that we've talked about are some of my favorites, but like there are a number that we really haven't even addressed that I absolutely love. So looking forward to what's coming in the future. We'll preview that a little bit later on in the episode. But to recap, the movies that we have covered so far, the 18 essential movies, are in alphabetical order: American Beauty, American Pie, Being John Malkovich, The Blair Witch Project, Boys Don't Cry, Election, Eyes Wide Shut, Fight Club, Magnolia, The Matrix, The Mummy, Office Space, The Phantom Menace, Run Lola Run, The Sixth Sense, South Park, 10 Things I Hate About You, and last alphabetically, and also most recent, Toy Story 2.
I was going to say, where's the thing we just talked about? But it hasn't come out yet, so no spoilers. Also, my teaser from the last episode was not right, because I teased the next thing, but we're doing this thing. I don't know. We're all...
You can't really tease this, because you teased the next thing that we're going to talk about.
Sure.
So if you want the spoiler to that, then... you can go. I don't, but like the thing that we talk about in the next episode is so obscure that I'm not sure that anybody would even be like, what the fuck is he talking about? That didn't come out that year. Anyways, as we talk about round two, the round two movies, again, for those of you guys who've forgotten, are 10 Things I Hate About You, American Pie, Being John Malkovich, Election, The Mummy, Office Space, Run Little Run, South Park, and Toy Story 2. Joey, I wonder, from the movies that we watched, thinking about them over the last couple of months, and when you rewatch them for the podcast,
or watch for the first time, there are at least,
or watch for the first time,
yeah.
Any surprises that stick out to you? Opinions that you had that changed? New things you discovered that still stick with you that you want to talk about?
Well, this season there were two first-time watches for me, and one of them was the one that I had been not bracing for, but be preparing for the entire time. Everyone's like, "You're gonna love this movie," and I didn't, because mm-hmm. The Mummy is not really for me. But I will give it another shot at some point. But the one that I did really like was 10 Things I Hate About You, which I thought I was gonna really like, and I wound up really liking it. But you know, I think there's, from here on out, it's not going to be bad. There's still so many good movies, obviously, but it's going to be sort of lesser just because we've covered most of the all-time great ones. So I think new ones to me will be more of a grab bag, but those are two pretty good first-time viewings. That's my big takeaway, that I'm glad that I saw those two. I'm glad that I found one that I really liked enough to watch twice in 2 days or whatever wild thing I did. And then The Mummy, even though I didn't, you know, love that movie, I like talking about Chris Klewe and sort of understanding why you two old men loved it so much and still love it.
Yeah, and I think that's important. That's part of the point, is mm-hmm. to understand sort of the context for a lot of this, a lot of this stuff. I would say that I was pleasantly surprised by two things, two of the more recent ones that we watched, the South Park movie and Run Lola Run. Mm-hmm. I was surprised by how much I still loved them, and loved them in sort of ways that didn't just be, you know, because there's those movies and or TV show episodes or whatever, or books that you watch and reread, and you love them partly for like a nostalgia value, and you like, you know, the whole script, and you're not really seeing anything new every time. And in both cases, like, they didn't just age well to me, but that I really was seeing like new things, and they felt still very relevant and like vibrant. And that was really cool to see that. I mean, I think obviously there's some examples. American Pie, I think, or American Beauty, I think, is the one that sticks out the most, is like when we talked about that movie with our guests, that it was like Yeah, we all liked it at the time, but like not anymore. Yep.
Well, I think that's the risk with like everything. Like there's movies that I've loved that I'm afraid that like, not that I'm like afraid of like it being canceled or like it not aging well, but like there's something special about anything, whether it's a book or a movie or TV show or whatever, that you have such fondness for the first time that even though you're like, this is one of my favorite things of all time, and yet you don't watch it again because you're afraid of like what it could be. And like, when I think to your point, like when it holds up and when you're like, oh, this is still good, it's even better. It's just like, oh, I was wrong, or I can relax, I can breathe, I can exhale, this still is good, and I'm right there with you.
Yeah, and like when we watched Office Space, right, I think there was even some new ways I understood that movie that I hadn't thought about before. But you know, basically my opinion of it has not changed. Like it's mostly great. And I still get a little bit tired towards the end of it. And like, I think the one that is kind of most interesting, if I have one that my, I'm not going to say like my opinion of it changed, but has been kind of cemented, is American Pie, right? Where I can still see why it worked when it worked and still sort of see the charm of it and sort of like what was admirable about it at the time, but also be like, this just does not work anymore.
Right.
This is just like, this is not a good movie anymore. But if you look at it in the trajectory of kind of, you know, where things were going with the teen movies. Now, I know that Office Space is one of your favorite movies of all time, and so it's hard for it to have any competition in this space, but is there anything in the last 9 movies that gives it any run for its money?
Well, I was actually thinking, not that question specifically, but overall, that I think we might not have had the highs from the first season, like specifically like The Matrix, I think, as a movie that you and I could arguably be like both of our favorite movie of all time, and like Fight Club and Magnolia and Eyes Wide Shut are like, you know, there's a reason we're doing the podcast to set it again and again and again. But we didn't have lows like we had. Like, I mean, American Pie, not great. But this season, we did not have American Beauty, and we didn't have Boys Don't Cry. Like, those, we dodged those bullets.
That's true.
And we got really lucky. I think, I mean, there's no number two. It's Office Space, like, a mile between. But then, like, I think Malkovich and Toy Story 2 are both, like, wonderful movies that I love. And they're not Office Space, but nothing is. And I love those movies, too.
If anybody hadn't seen any of these 9 movies, what would you like? And I'm almost like not counting Toy Story 2 because like of course you've seen that, but no, you can count that if you want to. What's the one that you would say, like, start with this?
I think 10 Things I Hate About You probably has the widest appeal. I think that's probably the safest bet for the most people. Not American Pie, not Malkovich. Like, as much as we all love that movie and like we had a great time talking with Brian, that is not a recommendation for most people, right? The same thing I think with Election is the same. The Mummy, maybe. The Mummy or 10 Things I Hate About You, probably. Because Run Lola Run's not for everybody. South Park's not for everybody. And everybody's already seen Toy Story. So like The Mummy or 10 Things, right? Like those have to be the ones that have the broadest appeal and are the most crowd pleasing things, right? Or no?
Yeah, I think so. Okay. No, I think that's right. And I'm trying to think of like the one that ages the best for me, where if I'm not worried about someone being like, oh, well, this is like clearly from 99. The one that I think is like, if you've never seen this, you got to see it, is Run Lola Run. And
oh, okay, really? Okay.
We talked about like the one bad thing about that movie really isn't about that movie at all. It's about the subtitles and about the way that the movie is translated, which is terrible, which is nothing about the movie whatsoever. And you can get over that very, very easily. But I was so impressed by how that movie just has not aged. Like, it's just so good. And it's quick and it's thorough, and it's the sort of movie that I would just unabashedly say to someone, like, if you've not seen this, go see this movie. And like, you will understand why people were freaking out about movies around this time. And again, like, it is technically a 98 movie, but it came out in the US in 99, and it definitely fits into that sort of like rebel atmosphere of movies.
Actually, with that in mind, I will say that this was a great season for shorter movies, like whether they're good or bad. That's like true. American Pie is like a tight 90. Office Spaces.
Yeah. Election's not that long.
Election's not that long. Office Space, I know that you have issues with it being long, but it's not long. Run, Lola, Run.
It's not long. No.
South Park is short. Yeah. Toy Story is short. Technically, Hit About You is not long, right? Like Malkovich and The Mummy are probably maybe 2-ish hours, and like they're the longest. Like it's
those are the longest. Yeah. Yeah, most of the movies in this are 90 minutes or less, or around that, which is great. I'm looking back on our first series, I'm like, oh, there's some long movies in there.
Well, yeah, I mean, whenever you like put on Magnolia and it's not just 3 hours, it's like 3 hours and 8 minutes, like comfortably 3 hours, you're like, oh, right, we're gonna be here a while.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Okay, so I, as with last round, I have listed a couple of categories for round two winners. And what is the winning category thing?
Most Bryans?
I thought about doing most Bryans, but that's only two, and it wasn't actually in the movies. All right, so here are the nominees for the winners of round two based on the movies that we've watched.
Cool, okay.
Nominee number one, High School. Nominee number two, Animation.
Mm-hmm.
And nominee number three, 1 Week by Bare Naked Ladies.
Yeah, okay.
Joey, what is the winner of round two?
Oh man, I mean, the 1 week thing was so funny when it came up. Back-to-back movies, so funny.
Inadvertently too, funny. Too, like I didn't remember that it was prominently in both of those movies when I scheduled it, so yeah.
I would also like to I would like to throw a fourth a shadow nomination here.
Oh yeah, all right, write in, let's do it. Sure.
Everyone's favorite subject, intro talk.
Oh, intro talk. Okay.
That good. Popped up yeah, three or four times like in a row too, right? So I'm going to say, wait, so it was High School?
Yeah.
Animation.
Yeah.
1 week. So Animation 1 week. Had 2 and a fraction in Run, Lola, Run. High Correct. School had 3.
Mm-hmm.
And 1 week had 2. Man, American Pie is really that like weight tying down the High School ballot. I'm gonna go Animation.
Okay, all right,
I think
okay,
it's 2 for 2 and High School is 2 for 3, and I think that there's, you know, there's a big difference in that batting average.
Yeah, and so okay, well, but also like Office Space started in Animation and Mike Judge was in Animation,
even more credit in my corner.
Yeah, no, I think that's right. And like The Mummy involves a lot of CGI animation and like stop motion stuff. And mm-hmm, so,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, no, I agree. And I think that the interesting thing about like having South Park and Toy Story 2 back to back is that one of them is this like incredible achievement of cutting edge animation and yep. like doing things no one had done before, and the other one is like, it doesn't have to be that good, you can still make a fucking incredible movie.
Well, what's also like, funny is the next thing we're doing is even shittier animation, right? So like we're on this little streak. It's
maybe, but like, yeah, well, so it's hard to say with South Park, because like it's not shitty animation. It's actually really sophisticated animation
right.
that they use for South Park. And there's a joke in South Park where Cartman's like, oh yeah, but Terrence and Phillip is like shitty animation anyway. And then like you see the side view of them just like hobbling along mm-hmm, with mm-hmm, no movement. Mm-hmm. And it's very funny. But like the reality is that South Park is actually pretty intricate and like pretty meticulous in the way that it is animated. So it's like great animation that is designed to look shitty, and like that's kind of part of why it's so great is that it's like you couldn't do shitty animation and make it look like that, right? You know, like that's right. that's kind of the whole right that's the whole point. Yeah, so again, like, oh, our last three movies had really the only animation in them, and two of them were animated. The reason I would err towards High School is that 10 Things is kind of a classic high school movie, mm-hmm. and American Pie, while not great, kind of is hugely influential in both paying homage to previous high school movies, but also setting a template for something that would happen after. And then Election is a movie that transcends high school movies in this really, really interesting way. While we're on the subject of Election, we talked in our Election episode presciently about the feasibility of there being a
sequel
to Election starring Reese Witherspoon. And because Hollywood bigwigs listen to our podcast and take direction from us, turns out there's going to be a sequel to Election starring Reese Witherspoon.
Yes, it's going to be a Paramount Plus series. Tracy Flick can't win because Tom Perrotta wrote the sequel, the follow-up novel, I think this year, maybe last year. But yeah, they're adapting it. And the most important thing is that Reese is coming back and Alexander Payne, they're both coming back, which is like, okay, so you have the talent, the team behind it. Maybe Chris Klein will come back. Who knows? But we can only hope.
Is he a character in the novel? Do you know?
I have not read either novel. I don't know. I've read a couple Tom Perrottas. I do not know. I have not read those, so I have no idea.
We talked about our Tom Perrotta knowledge in the episode.
And we did.
Yeah, I'm not sure if he's in the sequel.
We also talked about how the movie and the book end differently. So I'm wondering if they're going to retcon it or what they're going to do, because whether she's a politician or a high school principal, because I think in the book, she's like a high school vice principal or principal or something. So we'll see.
Yeah. I don't think they have to retcon it. I think you can just be like, yeah, my political career failed, so now I'm in this high school.
Because she can't win.
She can't win. I should read the book, and then I'll have a better sense of that. But we are hugely influential in the decision-making process in Hollywood.
Weird, and I know that like part of it is like we're talking about like things that like people love that like, you know, I know that there's like a little bit of confirmation bias. So like we're talking about like 18 huge movies and like news is going to come out about one of them. But like on Too Fast, like we would talk about a movie and like within 3 days it'd be like, oh, like possible sequels. Like no one's talking about this movie, but like there's enough things, like if you just talk about enough things, there's going to be coincidences. But like it does feel weird when we're like, hey, there's this book, it's probably going to happen, whatever, we just talked about it, and then it does. It's like, oh yeah, okay, cool.
Well, I keep saying 11 Things I Hate About You, but it keeps on happening.
Well, so. I mean, there's man.
Aside from Election, of the movies, and aside from Toy Story 2, because of course there's already a 3 and 4, but of the movies that we have covered.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I guess The Mummy would be exempt too, because there's a million mummies.
The Mummy is exempt. All right, so yeah, let's say this. American Pie, exempt. Being John Malkovich, not exempt. Election, now exempt. The Mummy, exempt. Office Space, not exempt. Run Low the Run, not exempt. South Park, not exempt. We only have 4 movies in that don't have some kind of a sequel.
And like South Park should kind of be exempt too, because there's a lot more South Park. You know what I mean? Like it's not a sequel, but there's a lot more South Park that you can consume. So
before I would have thought of this, as Election now is getting a sequel, that then reduces us to 3 movies. Being John Malkovich, Run the Run, and 10 Things I Hate About You.
Mm-hmm.
Of those 3,
yeah,
which would you most like to see a contemporaneous sequel?
Oh, man. I mean, a Malkovich sequel would be the greatest thing of all time, because like you don't do a sequel to that movie unless you have like the best idea of all time.
I agree.
I also, you don't do a 10 Things sequel because Heath has passed away. So that's
right.
And right. Like, I don't know, like Run Lola Run just ends so perfectly, right? Like, you know, she gets stuck in it. I don't know what I want. It has to be Malkovich, but it's also, I think, the least likely of the 3.
We said, I mentioned, I think, in the intro to Run Lola Run that one of the things that, Roger Ebert said is that like there better not be a sequel to this movie, because it's just perfect and like it ends exactly where you need it to. And while the characters are great and the aesthetic's great, like, it needs to not have a sequel. And I completely agree with that.
Like, it's kind of three movies in one. Like, it's not, but it kind of already is its own sequel in a way, right? Yes. So
I think I completely agree with you. Like, 10 Things I Hate About You, a sequel would be gratuitous. Although I'm intrigued by the idea of taking the two female characters and adapting a different Shakespeare play with them as adults.
Has that ever happened? That's a great idea.
So that's how I would do the 11 Things I Hate About You that I've always wanted.
You could also do like a 10 Things I Still Hate About You.
There's possibilities there that I think would be fun. And I think that, like, again, Disney Plus would be like, yeah, sure, fuck it, let's do that, right?
Right.
We'll make a movie of anything because
I think
it on there and
I think it also would follow, as sort of weird as it sounds, like directly in the Tracy Flick thing, where it's just like picking up the same characters years later, right? Like, it's not like,
yes,
because it's
yes.
so far after the fact that you're like, hey, what are those two women up to?
Right. Or like the Santa Clauses sort of a thing where it's like 20 something years later.
Stop talking about a Santa Claus, man. You keep talking about Santa Claus. You keep talking about Tim Allen. This is a wild
transition. Not yet. I haven't. but I completely agree that, like, I think a Being John Malkovich sequel would be awesome. And if done right, but, like, they wouldn't make it unless they did it right. Like, they wouldn't make it unless they had a really great idea for it. And I think there is a lot of fun things that you could do with that. So I think what's more likely is our first idea of a 10 Things sequel. But we shall see. Mm-hmm. But yeah, it's kind of wild to think that most of the movies that we have in this list have some kind of sequel.
Well, Hollywood loves an IP. They love an IP.
Didn't until we did our episode. So I'm not saying it was our fault, but it is. So sorry, Bare Naked Ladies, but you gave it the old college try, and you know,
I mean, that is the most 99 of the three options, though.
It absolutely is. Smash Mouth will play a big role in some of the.
Is there a Shrek movie in 99?
I don't think so.
I think that probably postdates it, right?
The one year there was a Shrek movie.
I will give you, speaking of animation, I will give you your own award. I laughed out loud this morning at the episode title of today's, as we're recording it. Because I was like, I don't know, because I don't usually know the word. Like, sometimes the word is obvious. But the lazy toy gun.
I will say, so I was going to mention this as well. I was looking at it. And I'm like, if someone hasn't seen this movie, they'll just think I, like, had a seizure and was just, like, typing random letters for the title of the episode. But if you've seen it, then you get
it. It's really, really funny. And it's really funny.
I assume that you've seen it. But I was like, holy shit. People would be like, what is happening to this podcast? They are just randomly typing out letters.
We kind of used to workshop them because, like, some movies are harder than others. Like, some are easier or whatever. And then, like,
yeah, that one was easy.
Yeah.
That one was super easy.
Lizardburn.
Lizardburn. I literally had this conversation in my head and I was like, do I want people to think I've had a stroke or something? But I was like, no, everybody's seen Toy Story 2. They will get the joke. It is ubiquitous enough, but no, thanks. So let's just take a quick look ahead at what is coming up next. Now, Joey, I know if you're a listener of this podcast and you're thinking to yourself, well, this podcast comes out on Mondays and next Monday is the day after Christmas. And so there's not going to be a Christmas episode.
Well, there's no episode next Monday. I can tell you that much.
This podcast, there isn't. But what if I were to tell you that there is a Christmas miracle in your future and that on Christmas morning, you can get up and unwrap your smartphone and your Spotify and your whatever, and there will be, under the electronic streaming tree, a brand new episode of 99 the Podcast about Christmas on Christmas morning that you can listen to on Boxing Day if you want to, the next day, which is the Monday when this is supposed to come out. So
I would say it sounds like a Christmas miracle.
Yeah, so that's not promising anything, but check your podcast feed on Christmas morning, because I've gotten good reports from your scout elves.
Ooh.
And sounds like you've all been good boys and or girls and or non-binary fans this year, and we love you.
I think we've teased the season 3 theme. Have we said outright what it's going to be? Should we say that now, or should we leave it as a mystery?
We have not, and I will say what it's going to be. So for season 3 slash round 3
of this podcast, the one that we're on.
The one that we're on. National podcast. We are going to do something fun. We've kind of been tied down for the first 2 seasons to this structure of trying to sort of you know, parse out the most essential movies. We're going to be a little more fancy free. This is our request series. So this is a combination of 2 things. It is either past guests and or friends and or fans who have specifically requested movies that they love and that they want to talk about. Or in some cases they are the opposite, where you and I have been like, I want to know what this person thinks about this movie.
Yep.
And so we have requested that they come on, but it is a 9 episodes of, let's say, listener requests. There are some really great ones here. It's a good way of dealing with some of the big ones that didn't make the cut of the first 18, but probably could have in a lot of cases. So yeah, we still have some really big ones coming in the next
once again round. Broken record, good year for film.
Yeah, good year for film. And then after that we are going to go to some back to some themes and cover some of the ones that we like don't want to watch but are going to be fun to talk about, even if they won't necessarily be fun to watch. But yes, so we'll be coming back with our first episode in 3 weeks from now, our first episode of season 3. So yes, on January the 9th, 2023, we are back with a big 1999 movies that is very beloved by a lot of people, and I'm looking forward to talking
about. What about this for an idea?
Yep.
It's a new year. We just move on to the 2000, the podcast.
Let's just skip the rest of them. No, because that's not anywhere near as good of a year, and we have way too many to talk about. But let's talk about 2000 in like 10 years. So we'll do a decade like of 99.
So if we did a first season,
then we'll
do a
decade of 2000, and then we'll be dead.
If we did 2000 the podcast, we could do American Psycho, yeah. Memento, Requiem for a Dream, In the Mood for Love,
I know, Gladiator, Shush, I know, Almost I know, Famous, I know, I know,
pretty
I
good.
Know,
pretty good, pretty good,
The Patriot,
Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, Aaron Brockovich.
Jesus.
Miss Congeniality, Dancer in the Dark, Oh Brother, X-Men.
If we're still in the, if the world exists and podcasts exist and we exist,
Best in
I think
Show.
We'll be done with this. Shut up. We'll be done with this in like 7 to 8 years. And so then we can move on to 2000. But
it would be really funny in like a dumb way that we're just like, oh, it's a new year. We got a new yeah. new movie. New,
ditch
new
year. This podcast. New millennium, new year, Y2K, the podcast. Mm-hmm. Or if we get enough people to listen to this, hint, hint, people, tell your friends, we could start a Patreon and we could do some Y2K for fun for our Patreon feed. So if that's something you want to hear from us, and you do, and you want to tell your friends about the podcast and give us a bunch of money, then we'll see.
That is a funny idea. Like, hey, this podcast with a very specific theme, pay them money, because then they don't do that theme anymore.
Well, Jen Tisdale really, really, really wants to talk about Dracula 2000. I've been trying to come up with an excuse to make that happen. Maybe that's what it is. So anyway.
Battlefield Earth.
Oh, God. Okay. I'm not watching that again. Listen, it's been a really, really fun 9 months. We'll be back soon with a special episode about Christmas. Mm-hmm. If you're good this year and behave yourselves. And then we'll be back to our regular schedule with all new movies shortly. But in the meantime, thank you for listening. We really appreciate all of the people who found us in the last 9 months. And that number keeps growing, which is really, really great. And we're very grateful.
Do we have any friends? Can people email us if they want to email us?
You can email us. We are at 1999@cageclub.me. Send us an email, say hi, tell us who you are, and unless you're Tyler Berth, in which case we already know, and thank you. Mm-hmm. We love you too. We'll be back soon. Until then, go
watch out for frogs.
Not the World Cup, because it's over. Boy,
Morocco. Can you believe
good
it?
Good job, Morocco.
Can you believe it? Won.
I can't believe they beat Argentina. That was amazing.
32-0.
32-0. Yes. In the first half. What is happening? What a game that was. All right. Look out for frogs. We will be back soon. And
bye.
Bye.
What is Roundup? Right here every day. Woody's Roundup. Come on, it's time to play. There's Jesse the yodeling cowgirl. Bullseye, he's Woody's horse.
He's a smart.
Pete the old prospector. And Woody the man himself. Of course, it's time for Woody's Roundup. He's the very best. He's the rootinest, tootinest cowboy in the wild, wild west.